Guess what? AI My Cars is done. It's now live. You guys can come check it out. If you're new around here, my name's Dylan. I just put a PhD in physics on hold to make some fun things, and my AI project for the cars is now live. If you want to turn your car into a supercar, a muscle car, a Lambo in like 10 seconds, come check out my website. You get a couple free spins, and there's already the credit and the subscription system implemented. Average tornado, 137 kilometers per hour. That's the fine structure constant. Most mysterious number in the universe, that one. They should have added quantum tornadoes in here. And no, I didn't just make that up. That is a real thing. Let's turn this up, shall we? EF0, EF1. We do not get a lot of tornadoes down here. Down under. There's been plenty of ideas of how, like, you could maybe throw a rocket or, like, a nuke into a tornado to sort of just stop it. Like, kill it in its path. And look, the theory behind using an explosion to stop a tornado, it's interesting, but I'm not sure it's practical because, you know, the consequences of shooting a rocket near a domestic area sounds like it's its own problem. Collateral damage, right? 35% of all annual tornadoes in the US. All right. Moderate damage. A dust devil is a strong, well-formed, relatively long-lived whirlwind. So a physicist back in like 2014 actually pointed to these two regions in China, right, that have a similar geographic location as the Midwest, right, but way less tornadoes. And so he thinks the difference is that China's plains are surrounded by three mountain ranges, right, which slow down passing winds that prevent tornadoes from forming. And so then he basically suggested building these mountain range size walls across Tornado Alley, like this big superstructure, which he thinks could end, you know, tornado disasters altogether in that region. No, we're not talking about Attack on Titan here, the wall. I was actually thinking about doing an Attack on Titan video next, so stay tuned for that. And they wouldn't be as hard to build as you think. Like, he actually laid out a plan for it. Like, they wouldn't, they'd be about the same height as skyscrapers, but way easier to build, right? Because it's just a wall. You don't have to do all that complex stuff you do with skyscrapers. 100-mile long bit would be hard, though, so I guess it actually is kind of like the wall in Attack on Titan. Ooh, the lightning. Largest water spout. 100 meters. It's impressive. So these water spouts, they can form when you have winds blowing in two different directions. They like run into each other and along the line of where the two winds meet, which is called a convergence line or a shear line, there is a lot of rotating air near the surface, right? And the collision of the two winds makes air move upwards because it has nowhere else to go. EF2. Considerable damage. Largest steam twister. EF3, 240 meters, significant, severe damage. You guys ever heard of a space hurricane? Yes, it's a real thing now, we've named it. It's basically just like a cyclone-like aurora thing going on. You basically have electrons spinning around like the central eye, and you know, they're raining down and they form higher up than normal aurora, and they can actually last for like 8 hours rather than just like minutes. And stronger tornadoes only account for about 6%. Fire whirl, largest fire whirl. That's terrifying. 500 meters? Terrible. Wow. A gigantic fire. Wait, what did it say? A gigantic fire whirl in 1923 in Japan killed 38,000 people in 15 minutes. What? Sorry, what? That's horrific. So you're probably asking, what the hell is a fire tornado? Basically, it's just this spiraling vortex of gases and smoke and fire. They're pretty rare because you need a lot of buoyancy from heating of the air from very hot gases coming off the fire. And that buoyancy will give the atmosphere this instability. But instability is probably not alone to create these fire tornadoes. You also need like a stack of winds shifting in speed or direction with height, right? And we call this wind shear. And the wind shear together with the intense heat could generate one of these things, which, you know, by the way, sounds horrible. Check this video out of a fire tornado turning into a water Spout. It's so cool. I'll just fast forward for you. So there's a little fire tornado, right? I'm sure you want to watch it. Epic. But then turns into a water spout. It's nuts.
Wow.
People that's riding past on jet skis.
The branches freaking from the thing is pulling them up in the air. We might have to go. I saw big trees falling.
Incredible.
Seriously, I saw logs hitting the water. I'm like, what is that? Because it's pulling them up in the air.
That is epic. That is the power of physics in nature. You have 600 meters, extreme damage. Around 1.1% of annual tornadoes. Have you ever heard of a roll cloud? It's basically like a horizontal tornado. It's pretty cool. All right, EF5, 1,000 meters. Very violent, extremely rare. I got less than 0.1%. Oklahoma tornado, 1,400 meters, terrible. So if you've ever seen a tornado in a movie or a TV show or anything before, you've probably got the idea that if you just stay away from the funnel bit, that you'll be all right. And it's just the funnel that'll, you know, cause, you know, you to spin up or something. It's not true. Don't go anywhere near those things, okay? I'm laughing, but it's not funny because this is, it's actually probably killing people from, you know, the way we portray it. A real life tornado is like a giant rotating area and the funnel is just the middle bit. You don't want to go anywhere near it. You're within a mile of the funnel, you're in trouble. Big troubles. Don't go anywhere near them. People get into trouble with these things all the time, like even experienced storm chasers, right? Because they don't even know this. You should not go anywhere near tornadoes, okay? It's not just the funnel that's dangerous. And not only that, they generally carry objects and things. And, you know, all of that stuff is actually a much bigger risk to your life than the funnel. So if you live in this region in the U.S., stay away. Fastest tornado ever. 1999 Oklahoma tornado. I can't read it. Get out of the way. This video is making me think of the butterfly effect, but don't worry, we're not going to go on a tangent. Significant tornado. Joplin tornado, 1,600 meters. Costliest tornado in U.S. history, $2.8 billion, 158 deaths. 2011 Joplin tornado was a catastrophic EF5 tornado that struck Joplin, Missouri. Another interesting idea to stop tornadoes is like, you know, those solar power collecting satellites in space. You beam down some solar energy in a concentrated form, right? Microwaves at these large storm fronts. And in theory, this could cause the cold, dry air to heat up at the top of these supercell storms, right? And that could prevent the dangerous updrafts that like cause these things to form, we think. The TriState Tornado, March 18th. Oh, why is it behind this damn bar? 1925, this was the deadliest tornado in the history of the United States. Okay. What does it say down the bottom? It's about to come up. And holds many other infamous records. Another outlandish but creative idea, you know, says we could use these solar satellites or mirrored lenses on Earth, right, to heat up the atmosphere in certain areas, which could maybe divert the path of these tornadoes, you know, away from inhabited areas. The precision, timing, and infrastructure, you know, necessary for these sorts of solutions are probably a bit difficult and expensive, right? So at least we know someone's on the job. The Moore tornado, 2,100 meters, 340 kilometers per hour. Damage, 2 billion. On the afternoon of May 20, 2013, a large and very powerful EF5 tornado ravaged Moore, Oklahoma. Jesus. What is this one? 1989, 2,400 meters. Deadliest tornado in history, 1,300 deaths, Bangladesh, 1989. It was costliest and deadliest tornado. There's still a lack of knowledge regarding how exactly these things form. Its predictions of these things are rather uncertain, right? Unlike hurricanes and other tropical storms that tend to have longer lifespans. Some of these tornadoes can form and disappear within seconds, right? And some can carry on for like an hour. But on average, I think they last for more or less 10 minutes. But, you know, they obviously do a lot of damage in that time. Bangladesh is history. Doesn't it say the worst one in history? It was the deadliest tornado in history. Okay. Well, then what's this one? Largest tornado ever. Deadliest tornado in history. Okay. El Reno tornado, 4,200 meters, 475 kilometers per hour. Only 8 deaths, 40 million. El Reno tornado was a very large EF5 tornado that occurred over rural areas of central... Can't read it. Every year in the US, the government meteorologists tell the public about, you know, how many hurricanes they can expect during, you know, the season of them. But the government doesn't do that with tornadoes. We have very little skill in predicting tornadoes. It's below my screen. Wow. You can really... Oh, that's why. Oklahoma during the early evening of May 31st. I will not put a human for comparison because it would be impossible to see. That's crazy. 10 meters average tornado in this. Look at this thing. Wild. I don't say thank you enough. And so I just want to say thank you to everyone who's been supporting what I've been doing and even the videos. I hope you guys are still enjoying this stuff and at least having a laugh or some fun sometimes. That'll do for today's video, guys. Hope you enjoyed. I'll see you tomorrow.